Hello, good evening guys. So today the question is on trusses. So DJ Sangi guys, you said me to go through the manual, and these two questions I already had posted videos. So if you want, I'll make separate videos for these questions as well, but these are similar to the questions I have already posted. So moving to the different type, which is a third type, which is based on truss, right? So practical number three was on trusses in SOAR's practical also. So today we'll be doing analysis on trusses. Now the difference in truss is here we use link elements, and aim to use link elements is because you have been given an area and you don't have been you haven't been given a cross section. So also a catchy point in the first question is this question is not to be done with beams because you have been given an area and not a cross section. So if cross sections like see here 20 cross 15 is given. So if such a question is given, you have to use link instead of beam elements, right? So now today I'll show you how to use link elements and why only area is given for using link elements. Okay, so let's start. We'll go into APDL as you know, and I'll go directly open it because I have already started it. So yeah. Now today we are performing a structural analysis again, and it's not thermal, so we'll go into preference and set it to structural. I hope you know this by now. And we'll go into preprocessor. We'll go into element type. Now today instead of adding a beam element or a solid element, we'll go into link element as we require. We have been given only area of the cross section itself. So now here we'll be defining the 3D finite stationary 180 link. Now this is just if you select actuator link, it is for more complex analysis. So we'll be just be using this link, and we'll click on OK, and this link is added. We close this thing. Now we have to go to material properties, go to material models, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic, and yeah. So yesterday in my video, I have mentioned it in 2 into e power 11, right? So this was converting it into Newton per meter square. Now the problem in Newton per meter square is the displacement we get is in meters. So to compensate with that, and if we don't want it in Newton per meter square, so what we can do is we can keep it as 2 into e power 5. Now what this does is the question is of 200 GPa, right? So what this does is, what 200 GPa while we do 2 into e power 5. So what this does is it uses only, it converts into megapascal, and megapascal's unit is Newton per millimeter square. So Newton per millimeter square, and that's what we need, right? So we'll keep it as 2 into e power 5, and Poisson's ratio is not given in the question. So since the Poisson's ratio is not given in the question, we can set it to 0.25 or 0.3, whatever is required. So yeah, we'll set it to 0.25 and we'll click on OK. So material is added. Now in the question there is only need of one material because only one property is given, so no need to add any other material. We'll just click on cross and we'll proceed to for further analysis. So now yesterday in one video there is a section, there is a point where I didn't use this sections tab. So why this is done is section is required only in case of link or a beam element, and area element doesn't require section or anything. So now in our case it's a link element, so we have to add a section, and it's asking for an ID. So now what an ID is just a name, like we used to give in the beams, we used to give it some ID or something. So it was ID number 1 or 2, so I'll just keep it as 1. Click on OK, and now it's asking for section name. So I'll keep it as 50 because the area is of 50 millimeter square, and I have to remember that. So now the area is in 50 millimeter square. I'll click on OK, and yeah. So the link area and section has been added. So if you want to check it, edit, and see this, you can see it's 1 and 50. And if you click on OK, you can see the link area and all. ठीक है? So now what the next step is to do is to go into modeling, and you have to. Now yesterday I said ki I would be teaching you how to mesh via nodes or how to go via nodes. So now instead of using lines and key points, I'll be using nodes and elements. Now what this does is this I guess prevents you from meshing things. So we'll proceed further and see how things goes. So instead of using lines and key points, I'll be using nodes in ActiveCS, and I'll be just giving it one. Location will be, because the first point is always at origin, so I'll be giving 0. First point will be 0, 0, and 0. And I'll click on apply. So we can see the first point has appeared here. It cannot be seen because of this access kind of thing. And we'll go to keep it as second point. And now second point's location is 50 mm above from this origin. So the y coordinate changes, but the x coordinate doesn't change. So we go into 50 and click on apply. Now you can see the second node has appeared. We'll go into 3, and now the 50 remains the same. The z coordinate doesn't change, but yeah, the x coordinate changes to 100. So we'll go into this and change this to 100. So, and I'll click on OK. So now you can see all the three nodes are there. Now you have to join those nodes via elements. Now what element does is elements, element attributes. You go into element attributes and you can see you are having an element type. Like it's asking for which type of element you have to add and what will be its cross section or what will be the link section number which we have defined already. So this will be 50 and this is the link type of element, and we'll click on OK. But how to add? So you will see the auto numbered kind of option. You don't see anything as add, subtract or something. You'll see auto numbered option. There you can see through nodes. So now it's saying to connect nodes. So what you'll do? 1 to 2. Click on apply. Don't click all the three together. Now click 2 to 3 and click on apply. This will create the second line, and 3 to 1 or 1 to 3, whatever you require, and click on apply. So this will create three nodes and an element. Okay. So now click on OK, and this is done. Now what happens in this case is, now the next step I think might be saved. So just I'll be back just a second. Yeah, so I was gone because I wanted to see what will be the force, and so I could give you the exact value, because this is at angle of 40, right? So now in this case, since we have used nodes and elements, as I said, meshing won't be required. So just forget this mesh, and we directly have to go on loads. Okay, because we are using nodes and elements kind of thing. If you would have used beam and the key points wala thing, then we would have to mesh. But since we are using this, we do not require meshing wala option. So directly go into loads, go into define loads, and click on apply. Structural, yeah. So structural, these two nodes are completely fixed. So we'll go into displacement on nodes, and we'll select 1 and 2, these two nodes, and click on apply, and I'll set all degrees of freedom to 0 and click on OK. So yeah, so now all these two are completely fixed, and as you can see, the APDL always sometimes glitches. So yeah, now we have to add load in here, right? So to add load here, go into force, and go to on nodes, because now we don't have key points, we'll require on nodes. Okay, and select this node, click on apply. Now it's asking for fx, fy, fz. So as we can see, this thing is at an angle, so it's neither in fx and nor in fy. So we have to give components of this. So this will be 10 cos 40 along fx in negative direction, and 10 sine 40 along fy in negative direction. So 10 in negative direction, 10 cos 40. So 10 cos 40 leads to 7.66 kilonewton. That means 7660 newtons. 0.44 is there, so we can add some points, and this will give some accuracy. I'll click on apply. See, the force is added in this direction, right? And another force we have to add, which will be in downward direction. So I'll again click on this node, I'll click on apply, and now we have to change this to fy and change this value to 10 sine 40. So what 10 sine 40 comes out is, just a second, yeah, 10 sine 40 comes out to be 6427.876 newton. So this will be minus 6427.876 पॉइंट 876 न्यूटन्स. ओके एंड सिंस इट्स द वैल्यू इज नोन आई विल क्लिक ऑन ओके. सो दीज टू फोर्सेज आर नाउ एडेड. वी हैव कंस्ट्रेंड दिस टू रीजन एंड नाउ जस्ट वॉट वी नीड इज द सोल्यूशन. सो वी आर डन विथ प्री प्रोसेसर. नाउ वी हैव टू डू सोल्यूशन. गो टू सॉल्व करंट LS एंड क्लिक ऑन ओके. सो एज यू कैन सी इट शोज सोल्यूशन इज डन. सो वी विल क्लिक ऑन क्लोज. Close this thing. Go to general post processing. Go to plot results. Counter plot. Nodal solution. Degrees of freedom solution. And click on X component of displacement. Click on OK. Yeah. You can see it's deformed in X direction as well. Also you can see it will be deformed in Y direction. So what we can do is we can do displacement vector sum and click on OK. So what this will show is it will show in deformation both in X and Y combined. Also, we require this will be your second screenshot, the first screenshot being the load applied. Okay, and yeah, so now what you will do is go into elemental solution, go to stress, and go to Von Mises stress and click on okay. So, see now what this is showing is this is showing all the stresses generated in all the beams. So, one thing we can do is go to plot. Go to style, size and shape and turn on the element display and click on OK. Yeah, so this shows is just a second, I'll go into ISO view. Yeah, this shows the different stresses in different elements. See, it is showing 287 in this element. It shows 31 around 31 in this element and the middle value of 95 in this element. So this is because you applied the stress in along 40 degree itself, right? So this is completely fixed and these are your stresses. This will be your third screenshot. Okay, so thank you guys. This was for the experiment of truss in this case. Yeah, I'll explain you how to do in this case. Okay, so here the length is given as 105. So how will you describe the coordinate system is you'll go and you will just give this as 000. This will be 105. Now to determine this location, you can split, you can consider this right angle triangle here. I'll just draw it so you can imagine. Yeah, you'll consider this right angle triangle here and you know this length will be half of 105. So 105 by 2, right? And this will be 105 again. So using Pythagoras, you can find this length that will be under root of 105 square. Minus 105 by 2 the whole square. Okay, so whatever this length is, you will get this node. So you have to give 105 by 2 in x dimension. X will be 105 by 2 and y coordinate will be this thing. Okay, so these will be your coordinates. And yeah, similarly you can define nodes and elements and everything will be else will be same and you just have to calculate this thing. Okay, so yeah, thank you guys. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.